Shall we play a game?
All right, here we go. Let's go ahead. Resume. White Shoe Slam.
Good morning, gentlemen, and what a grand morning it is, too. We have just cause for celebration. Galloway and Phelps are sending another fiend to San Quentin. A nice showy trial, and he'll be strapped down with gas seeping into his tiny reptile brain. Now, the fresh business. Galloway and Phelps, the task is at hand. The address is on the hill, north downtown off Fremont Avenue.
Skipper, is the new letter genuine?
Now, boys, we all know how many imbeciles have confessed in the short case.
I mean, you know you've made it.
Ray Pinker will let
us
know in good time.
All right.
Fine morning indeed. We keep locking them up, but the bodies keep piling up.
Yeah, California's love affair, though. As long as the bricks hold up at San Quentin, there'll always be killers in this town to send.
Greetings from sunny California. When's it gonna stop? First the letter, and now another body. Come on, you can't keep on telling me there's not a killer still out there.
You know, Phelps, all these arrests on your record are giving you a reputation. You don't want them turning into unsolved.
Getting a vicious killer off the streets is more important than my reputation.
Really?
And besides, landing a big fat marlin is more impressive than an ocean full of minnows.
The minnows maketh the man, Phelps. You can't always hit home runs. Sometimes you just gotta make first base.
Detectives?
Phelps and Galloway, homicide.
Scene secure. The rest of the patrolmen are going door to door, canvassing for witnesses.
Thanks. Keep me informed.
Will do, Detective.
This looks awfully familiar.
I think that's the impression the boys from the Examiner took with them as well.
There's nothing original under the sun. Why should murder be any different?
What do we have so far?
Not much trace evidence to speak of. Storm blew in around 10 last night, and the rain washed most of it away.
And the body?
Looks like she was tipped out of an automobile from the tire tracks and superficial injuries. Strangled with a length of rope. And for my money, it's triple braid again.
Time of death?
From her temperature, maybe 2 a.m. But it was cold last night.
Usual head injuries.
Blunt force trauma. Knock him over the head, then strangle and mutilate. No message with this one.
At least she was left clothed.
I doubt very much he was concerned with her dignity.
The green silk dress is very distinctive. Any sign of her other shoe?
No. And no handbag or other personal effects.
All right, let's go. Let's see. Funny.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
Well, I mean, you know, you could take it anyway just to see, make sure.
That's what I think. I've seen it all. No drag marks. Killer was moving around, surveying the scene. Our driver and our killer are most likely one and the same.
Anything else?
It appears to be a dry cleaning label. Superior Laundry Services, F1363.
Ring again? Nope. So there, it goes back there.
Detectives, I've been working the houses across the street and up the block. This lady thinks she has something for us.
Detective Phelps, LAPD.
I'm Mrs. Barton, Catherine Barton. I live just across the way.
Okay.
Did you see anyone around here last night?
Not last night, but yesterday, early evening, I saw that awful hobo.
Okay.
Do you have a description?
Tall, gaunt, horribly disfigured. I think he may have had an accident in the war. He's a very scary, angry man.
Any idea where we might find him?
One of the hobo camps around here. He's some kind of hobo leader. They all follow him around.
Thank you, ma'am. You've been a big help.
Of course. Anything I can do to help. I'd hate to think that something so ghastly could happen right here and nothing be done about it.
Okay. So if this is let up, I'm wondering if there's some kind of call I need to make.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on Superior Laundry Services.
Just a moment. Superior Laundry Services, 1260 West 1st Street.
Can you track down reports of hobo camps in the vicinity of Signal Hill?
Just a moment, Detective. There's a large camp under the bridge on Grand between Temple and Sunset.
Thanks. Can you keep things under control until Pinker and Carruthers finish up?
Sure, Detective. We'll stay out of their way.
I'll call you when I know something. Meanwhile, get on with the case.
Hmm. I know it's probably nothing, but. Where's he at? Already in the car. Okay. Hobo camp. Yeah, I want that one. We'll go that, and then I'll have him drop to the other one. I hate that.
You know the way. You can drive.
Oh, God damn it. No.
No message.
Excuse me?
There was no message.
Where?
On the Vic. The last bodies had something written on them. This one didn't.
I'm failing to follow you.
Can't be the same guy is what I'm saying, right? Before you start trying to link this to Maldonado and all the others.
There are more factors to consider than the messages, Rusty.
This doesn't fit your pattern, Cole. End of conversation. Understand?
Okay, go ahead.
11K, roger. Citizen reports at 415 at Alvera Street Plaza. 11K, it's code 3.
Slow and steady, come on!
If I'm crazy, it's your fault. Running around behind my back. How am I supposed to trust you, goddammit?
Whoa, sir. I think you ought to calm down.
Mind your own goddamn business. Why is everybody always on my case?
Okay, now this guy cannot run a fast.
Watch it!
Mr. Don't shoot me!
Give it up, old man!
What the hell?
The bastard!
Get the bastard!
God dang, what the hell? Can't tackle him? I was trying to tackle him. I guess I can't.
Entry into the possible 415 at Alvera Street Plaza, Unidan, code 3, identify.
11K.
You're crazy.
If I'm crazy, it's your fault. Running around behind my back. How am I supposed to trust you, goddammit?
Whoa, sir. I think you ought to calm down.
Mind your own goddamn business. Why is everybody always on my case?
Officer down! Watch it!
Don't shoot me!
Give it up, old man!
What the hell?
The bastard!
Get the bastard!
Reinforcements on the way. Cease and desist.
Cover me!
Oh.
Oh, I didn't want to kill him. But
car 11K. Code 4 at Alvera Street, but I'll need an ambulance. Shots fired. Suspect is down.
Roger on your ambulance, 11 King. All units be advised, code 4 at the Alvera Street Plaza.
At least the rain stopped. You can change back into those white bucks now.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. We're investigating a case, and one of your laundry labels came up. F1363.
If you give me a minute, I'll go find a register, and you can take a look. You take a look for yourself. I've got clothes that need pressing.
You wrote the number down on that dress, is it there?
This is T. Terrelson, 43 Emerald Street, Westlake.
All right, thanks.
Can you drive to this one?
Fine. Where are we headed?
I've got a feeling we're about to meet another wife killer.
You've always got that feeling, Rusty.
Yeah, and it's usually correct.
Please, please, for once, can you not let your assumptions color your detective work?
Just you wait. Nordic types show a particular disposition for this stuff.
Here we go. Okay.
Hello? Yes?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. Is your wife home, sir?
My wife went out last night and she hasn't come home.
Can you describe your wife and what she was wearing?
We were out at a friend's place, Bobby Ross's, for a party. She was kind of dolled up. She had her green silk dress, open-toed white shoes. Those are her favorite shoes.
Can we come in, Mr. Tarleton? I'm afraid we have some rather bad news. Do you have someone who can look after your children, Mr. Tarleton?
I've been trying to arrange a sitter. Look, tell me what's happened.
I'm afraid your wife was murdered last night. Her body was found this morning. We're very sorry for your loss. I know this is a difficult time, Mr. Tarleton, but we are going to need you to answer some questions. First, we're going to take a look around.
What for? You don't think
it's
that...
procedure. You see to your girls.
Stay here till Daddy's finished talking to these men.
Where's Mommy?
Everything's gonna be all right, sweetheart.
We would like Mommy to come home now, Daddy.
What's the problem, Terrelson? Let him search. You got nothing to hide. You want to hear something funny, Terrelson? Some bums think filling out a missing persons report actually rules them out as a suspect.
Need to check if she was a regular. I wonder why the picture was turned down.
It. I think that's it from there.
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that.
Nothing significant. Baron's bar again. Someone must be real sweet on this dive. If you'd excuse me, ladies. This isn't what we're looking for. So she went out without her handbag? At least she was spared that particular indignity. Quite a state to leave this behind.
A one, two, okay. It's my same one.
We could see if Pinker can match the impression to the crime scene. Lars was out in the rain last night.
Looks like a match with the ligature marks.
Damn, this dude is... Was it? Oh, there it is.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Can you run an address for a Bobby Ross? Then send some uniforms over.
Would you like him picked up?
No. Suspect says he was with Ross last night. We need to confirm the alibi.
I'll get a prowl car dispatched.
Thanks for your help.
All right, here we go.
For the record, Mr. Taraldson, what is your wife's name?
Teresa.
Whew, okay. Time of death, boot prints. Damn it. Because can that?
If you have more questions, I'd rather get this over with now.
Cannot. Ah, damn it. Should have checked the car. Well, it would have. Never mind. Bow rope. Good prints. Muddy boots, wet jacket.
Do you have any idea why anyone would want to hurt your wife?
No. Everyone loved Teresa. She was so full of life. It can't be anyone who knew her.
Did you ever play this, Artie? I don't want to waste an intuition on it. Yeah, it's hard to... it's kind of weird. Some of the stuff doesn't make sense, but for the bulk of it, it does make sense. Like their facial stuff when they do stuff, like right now. I don't know. He looks like he's telling the truth.
Comfort my daughters now.
I'm going to go with truth. Mm.
So you don't know.
Nope, that was wrong.
Dead.
No, I don't.
when it goes dun 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 dun, all separate tones, that means I got it wrong. If it does a little dun 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 at the end of it, that means I got it right. Shit.
You said you went to a party at Bobby Ross's place?
That's right. Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave.
Yeah. So, Bim, the guy that he's not on this evening, but he's watched most of my playthrough. He told me tips on this stuff, which be like, if you know there's lying, to make sure you have evidence for it. And if you're not sure, then you do a doubt. Wait, what did he say? I didn't pay attention. He said, that's right. Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave. So, okay. I'm going to use an intuition on this. Ah, damn it. I shouldn't have wasted it. I was going to say doubt.
You let your drunk wife leave.
See how it went ding.
Look, I was angry. I was having a good time. She has to go and ruin it. We always have to do what she wants to do. Last night she wanted to go dancing.
Any idea where?
Where she always goes. A bar down on North Beaudry Avenue. Baron's Bar. She goes there, drinks too much, gets maudlin, and calls me. I go and bring her home.
Okay. Victim state of mind.
Mr. Terrellson, was Teresa happy at home?
Yeah, I think she was.
So see how he did his eyes? That makes me think he's lying. Right. But my issue. See, this one was probably used in the first one when I said true, which it probably wasn't true. Matchbook?
Can I comfort my daughters now?
Shut up. I'm going to doubt it.
Spill it, Terrellson.
Yeah, that was right.
The look of you for this, so you better give us something.
We're at the party. She has a few and says she wants to go out dancing. We only have the sitter until 9. I get mad. I tell her to go ahead, but I'm staying. She storms out. Look, I'm doing well at cards. I hardly ever do well. I married her because she was so much fun, but now she drives me fucking crazy.
What time did she leave the party?
About 8:30, maybe a little earlier.
So you see on that one, if Bim... I call him Bim because he doesn't have a name. It's just BM215. If I didn't know the hints and tips that he gave me, then like I would have screwed it up like the first time, the first portion of this I played. I think I've played like the first two or three cases, and then I got kind of mad about, not mad, but like angry, not angry. Not confused, but aggravated, I guess the best way. But he told me, like, if you don't have anything for good evidence, then do doubt. And then the other thing is this musical play for clues. And then it'll stop Annoyed. Yeah, annoyed's the best way. Yeah. And then musical play until...
Can I comfort my daughters now?
Until the last clue, then the musical stop. And you have to have actually set it and change that in settings because Rockstar, for whatever stupid reason, defaults it to always play all the time. And you don't want it to. You want it to stop when you get the last clue. All that stuff helped because I know when I previously played it, I just kept looking around for clues and then fucking stop. Last contact with
Vic. When was the last time you saw your wife?
Around 8:30. The card game at Bobby's was wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here. I paid the sitter and went to bed.
So, nothing. Nothing like observing him makes it look like he's lying. You know, he looks pretty.
Can I comfort my daughters now?
And there's really nothing. I mean, I guess I could say, yeah, I'm looking at them. These are the clues right here. So he had a wet jacket. He had muddy boots. So these two. I don't know if that's enough to say that. Yeah, I don't know if that's enough to say that he's, you know, that would make him, right? He says, card game at Bob's wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here, paid the sitter and went to bed. Oh, man. Wait, why can't I ask him a question of who the fucking sitter was? That would be huge. So, this is the stuff that I just found here. So, he doesn't look like he's lying, even though.
Can I comfort my daughters now?
Like, you know what I'm saying? His eyes aren't darting around. He's pretty stoic.
Can I comfort my daughters now?
But he has a wet jacket, muddy boots. The car, I played out my hand and drove home here. Man, I might mess up, but I think I'm going to say true because I just don't have anything. I think that. I think I'm going to do truth. I still have to go. I got to go look at the Baron's Bar. I got to go look at the hobo camp. And they made it look like, anyway, I'm going to do truth and see.
Why did you only report your wife? Nope, wrong. This morning?
God damn it.
She would have called up last night from the bar.
I should have doubted it.
Thanks for answering our questions, Mr. Tarleton. You'll need to go downtown to identify your wife's body.
I should have taken her dancing.
In my experience, Mac, if you give in to broads, you'll be giving in to them your entire life. Sounds like the Tarleton broad had her last drink at Baron's Bar. We should check the place out.
Damn it.
Appreciate your time, sir.
The thing is that...
kind of rings true.
The thing is, at least on this, it's like Red Dead 2. You know, it's like... it plays out more like a movie than it does a game. The game's not real difficult to do, but, you know, it can make your life easier if you do the questioning right. But a lot of times you can, like, make your way around to you know, like, I questioned someone about a gun shop, and then there was also a clue about the gun shop. So I was gonna find out about the gun shop. Solving all the cases? What the hell, Artie? You start watching in my that's my first death. This is going to... oh, fuck. All right, here we go. Okay, before we start all this, because this is basically a replay of everything. And I know the route I'm going to do now. I'm going to do it a little different now. I should have shot the guy. In the meantime, though, I'm gonna refill my coffee. I'll be right back. Because this whole thing has to start over.
Hello? Yes?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. Is your wife home, sir?
My wife went out last night and she hasn't come home.
Can you describe your wife and what she was wearing?
We were out at a friend's place, Bobby Ross's, for a party. She was kind of dolled up. She had her green silk dress, open-toed white shoes. Those are her favorite shoes.
Can we come in, Mr. Tarleton? I'm afraid we have some rather bad news. Do you have someone who can look after your children, Mr. Tarleton?
I've been trying to arrange a sitter. Look, tell me what's happened.
I'm afraid your wife was murdered last night. Her body was found this morning. We're very sorry for your loss. I know this is a difficult time, Mr. Tarleton, but we are going to need you to answer some questions. First, we're going to take a look around.
What for? You don't think
it's
that...
it's procedure. You see to your girls.
All right. Let's see. I'm trying to run through this.
Stay here till Daddy's finished talking to these men.
Where's Mommy?
Everything's going to be all right, sweetheart.
We would like Mommy to come home now, Daddy.
What's the problem, Tarleton? Let him search. You got nothing to hide. You want to hear something funny, Tarleton? Some bums think filling out a missing person...
to check if she was a regular. I wonder why the picture was turned down.
Got it. That's nothing there. That was nothing. Nothing. I don't think there was anything in here. That's a little bit of foreshadowing there, letting you know that something's on the boat.
If you'd excuse me, ladies.
Yep.
So she went out without her handbag? At least she was spared that particular indignity. She'd have to be in quite a state to leave this behind. We can see if Pinker can match the impression to the crime scene.
Lars was out in the rain last night.
What is that car doing?
Looks like a match with the ligature marks. Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Can you run an address for a Bobby Ross? Then send some uniforms over.
Would you like him picked up?
No. Suspect says he was with Ross last night. We need to confirm the alibi.
I'll get a prowl car dispatched.
Thank you.
All right, here we go.
For the record, Mr. Tarleton, what is your wife's name?
Teresa.
Well, we know that the first one's not true.
Do you have any idea why anyone would want to hurt your wife?
No. Everyone loved Teresa. She was so full of life. It can't be anyone who knew her.
Okay, I'm gonna doubt that.
For the record, Terrellson.
Nope, that was wrong. It was a lie.
Oh my god. No. I didn't kill my wife. And fuck you for suggesting it.
Wow. Can't believe it. What would have been the evidence for that?
You said you went to a party at Bobby Ross's place?
That's right. Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave.
Doubt?
You let your drunk wife leave the party and go off on her own?
Look, I was angry. I was having a good time. She has to go and ruin it. We always have to do what she wants to do. Last night she wanted to go dancing.
Any idea where?
Where she always goes. A bar down on North Beaudry Avenue. Baron's Bar. She goes there, drinks too much, gets maudlin, and calls me. I go and bring her home.
Okay, victim's state of mind.
Mr. Tarleton, was Teresa happy at home?
Yeah, I think she was.
Doubt?
Spill it, Tarleton. We like the look of you for this, so you better give us something.
We're at the party. She has a few and says she wants to go out dancing. We only have the sitter until 9. I get mad. I tell her to go ahead, but I'm staying. She storms out. Look, I'm doing well at cards. I hardly ever do well. I married her because she was so much fun, but now she drives me fucking crazy.
What time did she leave the party?
About 8:30, maybe a little earlier.
When was the last time you saw your wife?
Around 8:30. The card game at Bobby's was wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here. I paid the sitter and went to bed.
Okay, I'm gonna...
You're lying, Lars. You didn't come straight home, did you?
And how do you figure that?
Ugh. Muddy boots or wet jacket? I'm gonna say muddy boots.
Can I comfort my daughters now?
You were out in the rain. You got soaked, Lars. We found your wet weather gear.
Okay, I stayed a little later than I said. This cute little brunette was hitting on me. Teresa noticed. I was half cut. I walked her home from Bobby's, but nothing happened. I walked back and got the car this morning.
Thanks for answering our questions, Mr. Tarleton. You'll need to go downtown to identify your wife's body.
I should have taken her dancing.
In my experience, Mac, if you give in to broads, you'll be giving in to them your entire life. Sounds like the Tarleton broad had her last drink at Baron's bar. We should check the place out.
All right.
Appreciate your time, sir.
You believe this guy's story?
Kind of rings true.
Tomorrow, it's not far away. Oh, is it? You like him? Check the. I'll go to Baron's bar. Yeah, I messed with it. I think I played one mission with the driller and, but that was it, I believe.
Hey! So wait for the next turning and go right. You're taking the next left.
Galloway, LAPD.
I'm Benny Clough. This about Teresa Tarleton?
Yes, it is.
I heard about it on the radio. They're saying it was that Black Dahlia freak again? God damn it. Yeah, I rang that husband of hers. The babysitter said he was out.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
Okay. Last contact with the victim.
What time did Teresa leave?
Around 10:30, I think.
I'm a doubt.
We don't have time for
guesses.
What time was it exactly?
Hey, give me a break. I don't remember it to the second.
Damn it.
Who was she with? We've had reports about a tall, gaunt-looking hobo. He wasn't here last night?
I get plenty of bums in here, but nothing to fit that description.
I'm gonna doubt that one again.
The likelihood is that whoever she left here with killed her. Give it up, Benny.
All right, two creeps were all over her, promising to take her dancing.
You get a good look at these guys?
Sure. I got a good look. One of them was a sailor in uniform. His cap said, USS Indiana.
And the other man?
The other guy is Richard Bates. He's sitting in the back right now. Red polo shirt.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Bluff. We'll take it from here.
Hey, no problem.
This is Bates.
That's him.
LAPD, don't make me chase you, shitbird. You can't let the son of a bitch get away.
I brought his socks in it.
Bates, we just want to talk.
Come on, we gotta run.
There we go.
Get in and drive.
Fuckers run like a track stars in this. Oh, come on, bruh. Come on, jump in, bruh. Okay, I guess we're not gonna jump in.
No time to wait, Rusty. If he's the killer and he gets away.
Where'd you learn how to drive?
What the hell? Where'd he go? Is that where is that dude? God.
God damn it, get after him, Cole.
I thought you were gonna leave me there.
Who knows what this guy will pull when he's cornered? We could have a killer on our hands.
Let's end this farce.
I'll try to shoot out his tires. Wish me luck.
Damn it.
I don't think the killer would be kicking back in the bar where he met the Vic in.
Listen, a creature of habit is your killer. For some reason, they're sticklers for routine.
Watch out!
Come on, Phelps, you're letting this lust get away from you. He's showing you how it's done.
Don't go to sleep on me. Get me back in close.
Spin him out, or the world's wet.
All right, you got me. I've had enough.
Someone just flipped their wig.
Show me your hands. Okay, Bates, you're gonna answer some questions.
I have a choice in this.
Last night, you went drinking with a lady in the bar. Now she's dead, and your face is all messed up.
I'm in the clear on that. She preferred a sailor. You could lay it off on him. Are we finished?
Is there anything that...
Do you want my partner to sap you? Tell us what we want to know.
She was okay. Drunk. Pissed off at her old man, wanting to go dancing. I thought I'd ply her with a few drinks and get my end away. Looks like your salty had the same idea.
Account moments.
So what happened when you left the bar?
Sailor boy laid one on me. A cheap shot. After that, I don't know.
I'm gonna do doubt again. It's probably true, but
you've done time, haven't you, Richard? No. Is that why you ran?
I'm on parole.
On what offense?
Sexual assault. Look, I was lying there on the sidewalk. He flags a cab and jumps in with the broad.
We're taking you in, Bates.
How come?
Just for a chat. Nice private chat.
I'll explain my theory of once a degenerate, always a degenerate.
Take him to Central. He's a material witness in a murder case. Find him a cozy cell.
Richard here knows the drill.
Okay, so let's... Man, I'm so gunshot around across the road now.
Someone ought to take him home.
Thank you, ma'am.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Any messages for me?
Just a second. You have one new message from Lieutenant Fleischer. Bartender Benny Clough reports victim Teresa Terrellson last seen entering the yellow cab number 3591.
Can you have an APB put out on that vehicle? We'll need all sightings relayed to car 11K.
Sure, Detective. All radio dispatched now.
Were there any incident reports filed in the vicinity of Barron's Bar on North Beaudry Avenue? We're tracking a sailor who was involved in a fight outside the bar.
I can check the reports, Detective. I have a message for you from Captain Donnelly. Message reads, James Jessup, U.S. Navy able seaman, has information relevant to your case. Jessup is currently being detained at Central Station.
Could be our man.
Thanks, ma'am.
All right. What about that hobo camp?
Has that just been paid look about him?
You can drive.
And where exactly are we going?
Let's go to the hobo camp.
I think we ought to investigate the hobo lead.
Well, if you think we ought to, then I guess we ought.
I'll be right back.
Holy fuck. Never to leave me alone. If I fall, where's my wife? I'm the one. Nobody cares about me. I took a
We're looking for a tall man with a disfigured face. You know him?
Huh? What? I fought in two wars, you know, son. I think I earned some peace and quiet.
The bum isn't here.
We should follow the other lead.
These guys can wait.
I'll be right back. All right, let's see. Let's get back into it.
How come the cops can't ignore us the same way the government does?
Problem, pal? That's a guy from the papers.
Oh, yeah.
Big case.
You can't do this!
Nothing in there, nothing.
Are you linking up?
See him? I saw his picture in the paper. What's that case with the lady that got cut out? Like the dolly?
Oh, there's a dude in the mattress there. Whoa.
Sam is taking me to Palm Springs for the weekend. Son, you're a couple of slates short of a full roof.
You streak of piss!
There are three kinds of people. Those who can count, and those who can't.
I don't need this.
Where's he at?
What now?
Teresa's trail leads right to this cabbie's back seat, Phelps. We need to find him.
So this is probably...
I heard he's an honest cop. Now there's an oxymoron for you.
Hey! There's such a thing as soap, you know.
I have a feeling that I'm probably just...
Whoa! Easy!
He wants a five-star goddamn wedding.
That's disgusting. Didn't you ever hear of germs?
You can't do this.
Okay, this is unusual for this whole game where it doesn't give you some idea where to go.
Wish I could afford that. You're a real asshole, you know that?
Slow down!
Okay. I don't know if I'm even worth wasting my time on.
I don't need this.
Isn't that the cop who caught the guy who was pretending to be dead?
Hey, there's such a thing as soap, you know.
I don't know who you're looking for, and I don't want to know.
All right, well, I think I'm just spinning my wheels here. Am I supposed to go and... to each one? Yeah, let's go... We'll just go back to the station.
Can you drive to this one?
Fine. Where are we headed?
We'll hit the hobo camp if we need to.
I want to make a
comment. Okay. You know you can.
He's in interview too.
Thanks. What do you make of him?
Sailor on furlough who looks like he's in trouble and knows it.
I'm just praying the prince comes through so I can nail the son of a bitch.
Interview two.
Hey. You think those vice boys get any on the side?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. We know why you're here, Jessup. So it would be best if you answered our questions truthfully.
I don't want any trouble. That's why I'm here. I heard on the radio about this lady getting killed. I got leave from my CO to come down straight away.
So why did you kill her?
I didn't kill anyone. Look, you need to believe me.
Let's start at the beginning.
Okay.
You went to Baron's Bar. What time did you arrive?
I got a 24-hour pass. I got there around 7.
That's where you met Teresa Terrelson?
Sure. We had a couple of drinks.
Okay. Doubt.
So you tried to make a woman who was incredibly drunk?
Look, I'm not proud of myself, but I never hurt her.
You took her dancing?
That's right. Caught a cab to the Crystal Ballroom.
Okay, incident with Bates.
You had a fist fight with Richard Bates over Mrs. Terrelson.
You met the guy? He's a creep. You should take a look at him for this.
Okay. Nothing really that would throw it here, but I still... I'm still gonna doubt.
He's pointing the finger directly at you, Jessup.
I only had one night before I was back in the tub. He had all the time in the world to look for some action. I belted him. I'd do it again. She was better off with me.
Sure. You're a shining example of chivalry, Jessup. We're holding you till we can clear this with the driver.
Yeah, my CO said as much.
Can you put the guy in two in a cell and inform the commander?
Sure, detective. Got a message for you. Sighting of your disfigured hobo on Grand between Temple and Sunset. And it looks like the beau has a record, too. He's wanted in connection with two female assaults.
Thanks.
Where's the phone? That bum took a swipe at me. I put him down with my staff.
You know the way. You can drive.
And where exactly are we going?
Bumble camp. Again? Where we just came from.
Three suspects in the can and one on the hoof. And still no hard evidence on any of them.
KGPL to car 11K. 11K, come in.
11K, go ahead.
Cab?
Bobby Ross's car game is breaking up at midnight.
11K, roger that. Only have time to get downtown, Cole.
It's possible. Have them bring him in.
KGPL, could we have Lars Terrelson picked up?
11K, roger.
Damn, he got a shotgun. Rusty means business.
LAPD.
Oh, no.
We'd like a word with you.
Save it for someone who's interested. They're fascists. Come to move us on and steal what little we have left.
Six rounds won't get us far.
I need you to stay copacetic. We need to hold out until the cavalry arrives.
How do we do that?
Like this.
Holy shit.
We need to fight for it.
Your disciples know what you did last night?
God damn!
Joe Lewis.
What's your name?
Comrade Stoller.
Very funny. We'll find out from your personal effects.
Stuart Ackerman.
You're under suspicion for murder, Ackerman. We're taking you downtown.
You can't do anything more to me than what the Japanese have already done.
The Kremlin's over here, Phelps. Toss it, see what you find.
Okay, I'll come back to the newspaper.
Optimistic, Cole.
Oop, there's a purse.
Ackerman doesn't look like much of a dancer.
Oh, shit. What?
Looks familiar. Safe bet it'll match the mark under Teresa Terrellson's chin.
Man, it's all too tidy. No. Missing morphine.
Still working, Jack. I'm off to the Lighthouse Club in Santa Monica.
Hello, Jack. Mr. Benson, this is Courtney Sheldon. He's a buddy of mine from the war.
Well, I'm sure you two will want to polish some old war stories. Good evening, Jack. Mr. Sheldon.
Good night, sir. Take a seat, Courtney. We need your help, Jack. I told you I would have nothing to do with that. I'm fine too, Jack. Medical school's going well. I got a part-time job.
Do dope peddlers need part-time jobs?
We made a mistake and we're in trouble, Jack. A local gangster, Mickey Cohen, is putting on the squeeze.
So hand it over, walk away. What's stopping you?
We had a deal with them. That they would dole it out slowly. They said they would supply abortion clinics and doctors. But they've been moving it on to addicts. And they can't cope with the purity.
So your problem is with gangsters being dishonest?
My problem is that people are dying. And that if this gets back to us, we'll all end up in jail.
So how am I supposed to help, Courtney? This isn't the war. I can't just wave a magic wand and clean up your mess.
We want you to negotiate, Jack.
The only thing these guys understand is force, Sheldon. They got to the top back east by proving to be more vicious than the English, the Irish, and the Dutch. They make their own laws. That's the nature of a secret society. For God's sake, Courtney, you want to be a doctor. How can you fight with that?
We are better trained.
I didn't make it through the war to come back to this kind of shit, Sheldon.
Oh, I wish I could afford that. You can't do this!
Okay. Music's gone. That's all that.
What do you think?
Want another accommodation?
Okay. You don't think?
Try that again, asshole.
Well, let's go back, I guess.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Fine. Where are we headed?
Okay, how many have I got? Gotta interrogate. 2, 3.
The husband has an alibi, but no real motive other than neglect. Jessup's alibi checks out. Bates is a recidivist. He'll be pulling the same shtick until we put him away for good. Ackerman has history, opportunity, hard evidence. What motive?
We have the evidence. We know she was here. All we need is a confession, and we can charge the bum with murder.
We're going this way.
Where's Mark? Laundry, residence, public camp. Okay.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to stop them with one round.
Where are they at?
Help me out.
Come on. If Ackerman won't play ball, I'll rattle his teeth until he does.
Is he in this room?
Ackerman, you were in the Marines.
How do you know?
The Corps selected big guys for flamethrower duty. That's how you got the burns.
Life expectancy was 5 minutes for a guy in flamethrower detail. What kind of a government puts weight like that on a man's shoulders?
You'll get no argument from me. It was a heavy load.
You feeling sorry for this smelly fuck?
Okay. Motive for murder.
Why did you kill Mrs. Terrellson?
I have no recollection of the people I have killed.
Okay, doubt.
You hate women, Ackerman?
More than you could ever imagine.
How much did you hate Mrs. Terrellson?
I ache to put my seed in them. Afterwards, I have no use for them.
I attend to a music, a chime.
A bus driver dropped Mrs. Terrellson near your camp around 2 a.m. Why did you take her up to the hill?
Which hill? I have many places. I go where I please. You need me to sign some papers or something?
Yeah, there's tire tracks too, though. God, seem like he's set up. This doesn't sound right. I don't think. I don't know what a lie would be. Maybe I'll do a doubt.
You are clearly insane, Ackerman. The state of California does not execute mental patients.
I don't know the names of the women I've killed, but I've killed many of them. Their necks are so fragile.
Stuart Ackerman, I am charging you with the murder of Teresa Terrellson.
What the...
A man down on his luck, I can abide. But a filthy red who chooses to live outside the rules of society, I cannot stomach. Maybe poor Threes of Tarleton will provide the catalyst we need. I've spoken to the chief and the mayor, and I think it's time we send some men in to remove the godless and send them on their way over the county line. A grand day that will be, gentlemen. And a grand result you have brought me. You two are fast becoming my finest crusaders.
Wait. Clues found 12 and 17. What the hell did I... See, that one went way too quick. I knew I missed something. I missed something out of that case. I was wondering why they didn't direct you toward the cabbie. I don't like that.
And now my heart's a blazing ruin. You say that you were only fooling. Don't walk away. Don't do me wrong. Don't leave me singing this torched song.
We will look into it. Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year. Keep a hold of your hat, Counselor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve. It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawnbroker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue. We have another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to put him down in one round.
Oh, that bothers me.
Another body and Deirdre Muller's ring. The Emperor may soon have to come to terms with the fact that he's wearing no clothes.
Exactly. Did you get that book of riddles shoved up your ass, Phelps? Is that what your old man paid college tuition for?
There's five clues I missed. It had to be an entire...
This guy was willing to write his own mother after I sweated him.
Like taxi or something.
Guy gave his wife a cab. I said all to parents.
That's so annoying.
One
You've got to admit, this is looking odd.
Anyone could pawn a ring.
But if you take it along with all of the other indicators...
Cole, Hugo Moeller was identified by the school's ground...
Whoa.
He's our guy.
Witnesses have fingered the wrong guy before.
He ran, for God's sakes.
And he always maintained he was set up.
Ooh.
That's it, old man. I've had enough of your gibberish.
Holy shit.
Give it up, LAPD!
Yada, yada. Hurry! You can still catch him! Hurry! You can still catch him!
See him? Be careful. He looks dangerous.
Isn't he the cop they've been talking about on the radio? One another common dude?
Surrender now or I will use deadly force.
I don't know when I'll ever learn. I always think I can just like wound them and shit, but so I don't shoot them at the head for the head. Oh well. Okay. Let's see. Pawnbroker. Man, that case went a lot. Ah, I appreciate the follow. Pointless. With the follow, you can type in exclamation noir, which will turn my webcam black and white, or you can do rage, or you can do GTA. They all do different like lights and actions and stuff like that. So anyone that follows has the options or the abilities to put those commands in. But I appreciate the follow. Let's see. I don't know if I want to get into this case. Hmm. Yeah, I'm debating on whether or not to start up this case, because I hate starting up cases because I know I'm not going to probably finish it by the time I end the stream. Yeah, I've streamed quite a bit, and I've had one person pretty much. He's not on here this evening, but he's been on most of my stream playthrough. So he gave me a lot of hints and stuff to help me out. But a lot of times I just try to do maybe a case or two a stream. And I don't like to cut the cases in the middle of a stream because I can't stream every day. So it ends up being, you know, I'll come back 3 days later and try to remember where I left off in the case and stuff. So I usually a lot of times just like to work the case on one stream and then end the stream. And then, so my streams tend to be, because of that, at least on LA Noir, they're a lot more, they're a lot shorter than the other games I've played. At least each stream is. But yeah, I've always wanted to finish this game. I've started it a couple of times, but I only did a couple of cases and then would get frustrated with it. Yeah, and the if I played this every like if I streamed every day, then I wouldn't worry about it. But I don't. So like I'll stream tonight, but then I won't stream again until Friday. Because I work full time. So I telecommute on Tuesdays and Fridays, which ends up being the easiest days for me to stream. So I usually do Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. And I found out playing games that don't have clues that you have to remember and stuff like that was difficult when you span it over, you know, like Disco Elysium. When I played that, I'll put that in perspective. That was a difficult one because that was a detective type game. And when you waited 3 days to continue something, a lot of times I wouldn't remember where I left off in that entire playthrough. So I'd have to remind myself and keep notes. So whenever I started back up again, I'd remember. But yeah, I appreciate the follow. If you check my schedule, I usually go like 5:30 to 8 or something like that. Usually it's a case, but, which has been coming out to be about 2 hours and 10 minutes. I usually sprinkle in a little crime that's happening, but on that case I just did, I think I screwed it up. I mean, I completed it, blah, blah, blah. But I think the issue, I missed 5 clues. So obviously I didn't go somewhere where I needed to go. Which is annoying me right now when I saw it, whenever it came up. Because I'm just curious of what I missed out, which kind of bugs me. I'm not a big completionist guy, you know, 100% in games or anything, but that just bugs me because that's 5 clues. And I hope it doesn't hurt my... Because a lot of this stuff doesn't make sense. Like, it seems so convenient, a lot of these crimes, or the people getting charged for these crimes. So... that's the something doesn't sit right. So, did you ever watch, have you ever, watched the movie LA Confidential Pointless? Okay, so there's not a lot of places that stream it, but I know it's on, I think it's on Apple TV. If you like this era, this game, this time period, this detective stuff, this LA noir Rockstar pretty much lifted it and inspired everything from this game from that movie. The movie's a fantastic movie. It's, I think it was in the late 90s. I think 97 or 98, something, I think somewhere around there. But believe me, it's a fantastic movie. If you like movies and stuff, it's Russell Crowe and Kim Basinger, Danny DeVito. It's a like all-star cast. But yeah, it's a fantastic movie. But I'm going to have him drive over. Yeah, it won awards. It was a it's so good of a movie. Especially if you like this game, because a lot of this stuff, the new cop on the beat, you know, as you progress through the game, was in the movie. They have a cop that deals with Hollywood stuff, like this game does. It's a really good movie though.
You look at this,
and like I said, if you like this,
you're behind the wheel.
This era and stuff like that, it's really good. Okay, so it's saving here. It's 1:45, an hour 45. This might just have to be a short one. I don't want to start another case. This one looks like it might be a little, which is, I'm fine with playing longer, but I have that one to do and the rail yard. So this one might be a little longer, which will be good for Friday. If you haven't and you have Apple TV, then you're good to go, but I don't know how else you can get it. I have it, from way back. So, I have it stored in my digital library. But it's really good. Yeah, if you get a chance, I try to tell anybody that comes on here that likes, if they like this game, I try to mention that movie just because there's such a close connection. If you love this game, you would more than likely love that movie. If you love movies, if you like movies. I mean, some people, I think that's going to be it. I don't want to go and start this case right now. And Pointless, I really appreciate you following. And I'll be happy if you join Friday. Hopefully Bim would be there. You'll have someone that you can talk to. Artie, more than likely. Artie's a good buddy that I game with, so he might just have me on and making background noise. But I appreciate the follow, and if you check my schedule, check my schedule. It's Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday, 5:30 to usually a case, which is 7:30 or 8. I'd love for you to come back, chill out, watch the stream. It's pretty, I pretty much just drink coffee and vape while I try to solve crimes. So, right now, that's all I'm doing is pretty much story-driven games. I did Disco Elysium, which was, I don't know if you heard of that one. Then I did Vampire, The Masquerade, Bloodlines, which story-driven game. And then this one, of course. This is really a story-driven. This is more like a movie than anything, but yeah. Thanks again for the follow. I appreciate it, Pointless. I'd love to have you back on Friday. I'll probably see you in a little bit, Artie. But again, thank you so much. See y'all. Artie, Pointless, are you still there? They already take off. Oh. Okay. So I'm gonna play this for you, Pointless. I usually when I ask someone to follow, I don't really ask them to follow. I play this when I take a break. Most people get a kick out of it, but I spend a lot of time on it, so I like to show it. But this is me entertaining way for me to ask for you to follow me. So if you don't mind, this is about, it's about 3 minutes, but hopefully you'll get a kick out of it. I'll play it real quick.
Who is it?
It's Troy.
You're 2 hours late.
I know. It's her fault.
You got the money?
$2,000.
Hold on.
Hallelujah. You're my savior, man. My own personal Jesus Christ.
If you get caught using that.
Yeah, I know. This never happened. You don't exist.
Right.
Something wrong, man? You look a little whiter than usual.
My chat, it... You ever had that feeling when you're not sure if you're awake or still streaming?
All the time. It's called mescaline. It's the only way to fly. Hey... Look, it just sounds to me like, you know, you need to unplug, man. You know, get some R&R. Hey, what do you think, Deshaun? Should we take him with us?
Definitely.
No, I can't. I have to stream tomorrow.
Come on. It'll be fun. I promise.
Yeah. Sure. I'll follow.
Why? You never seen that, Artie? You never saw that? Oh, hell yeah, dude. I love it. If you can't, I love movies more when I was in my 20s and 30s. Oh, when I was growing up. And then, you know, in my 40s, I pretty much started playing more games. But yeah, that's not what I do for a living. I'm an IT person, but I like doing that stuff. And so it's just interesting to me. And so during the break of like Christmas and New Year's, I created that, kind of put it together. But I like doing that. But I thought you'd already saw it, Artie. I guess I never showed it to you. But again, I appreciate it so much, Pointless. Thanks. I appreciate it. I have a couple, but not to that degree, not to that level. You know, my intention was I was going to do, like, for each game I played, I was going to do a little something. But to do it to that level, it's a lot. It takes a lot of time. And so a lot of the stuff was made before I even started streaming. So like pretty much everything you see, like all the little graphics and all that stuff, was created way before I started streaming. I created all that stuff. Initially, I graduated with a graphic design degree, but I never really used it. Because of where I lived, it was just easier to get an IT job. So, to test out, Pointless, if you don't mind, so you could do, like exclamation mark, noir in NOIR. That's the special command I made for when I'm playing, LA Noir. And it will, it'll change my webcam to be, or Artie, either one of y'all. Yeah, there you go. See, so now it made me in the, you know, the LA Noir kind of thing. It might take a second, but you could do, if you do it again, it'll change it back. And then so yeah, if I'm playing and you want to do it. Yeah, you did it. I was getting ready to say, why didn't it work for you, Artie? That's because you misspelled it. Yeah, but it changes it back. So another one is, so like do exclamation GTA. And either one of y'all can do it. it's just stuff to, like, you know. And the other one is exclamation rage, and that just has the stuff go red and has Yosemite Sam cuss and stuff, but or not cuss, but you know, it might be there might be a cooldown, Artie. There isn't one with Noir because it goes Because if you want to remove it, I didn't want to put a cooldown on it. But like the rest of them, there's a cooldown on it. So you can only do it and then... So it's not getting spammed, basically, is the reason I put the cooldown in there. Because if someone's watching them, you know, I might bug them. But yeah, I have all kinds of stuff. I haven't really found a time to use them all. Eventually I'll use them. But like I created like the all that stuff. There's a bunch of goofy stuff like that. Now, I haven't put it out there, Artie, because eventually I might have to start putting it in my title or something. The reason I haven't yet is just I was just waiting. Like, get a couple of games under my belt, and then... Because this is only my third game to stream. So... But... Yeah. I'll show y'all another one real quick. This is the one I made for Disco Elysium. I'm gonna preface this by saying this is not made to even close to the what I did the Chatrix with or Chatrix. One, this is more of a joke one, but this is what I made for when I was playing Disco Elysium. So that was more made as a campy kind of joke one. And, you know, it still took me a while to do it, but kind of had to almost like do a rotoscope thing around the thing, whatever. But yeah, that one's more of like a joking fun one. You know, put my face on it and, you know, animate it type thing. But yeah, that was the intention. But then whenever I was going to do an LA Confidential one, the one I was talking about, Pointless, where similar to the Matrix one or the Disco Elysium one, but I just, you know, I knew it was going to take a while. And I mean, I don't have the time to do it. What I might do is my next big one I play or plan to play, I might try to make another one during the break again between Christmas and New Year's. Yeah, but that one's so long. I don't think Twitter goes over 3 minutes. I don't think you can do it over 3 minutes, or can you? I don't know if you can. But I'll check. I know one of them you can. I don't know if it's Instagram or TikTok. One of them changed it where they could, you could do it, you could post stuff that was 3 minutes. Or they increased it up to 3 minutes, where initially it was only a minute, I think. That's why the Disco Elysium one was done under a minute. Because that one's done where it wouldn't be, I could post it on any of the, like, I think Twitter, Instagram, any of those, because it was under a minute. But okay, since I'm showing y'all all of them, do y'all want to see the very first one I did? I did the very first one I did. I was going to do it under Cyberpunk. Wait, need to make your stream Twitter and add Twitter. Okay, so the very first one I did, it's short too. It's a short one. It's under a minute, I think. And it was done for the intentions to either play Shadow when I'm to play it while I'm doing, or to run it while I'm playing Shadowrun or Cyberpunk. I was going to do it while I was playing. I don't want to tell you what it is, but because it'll give it away. But this is the first one I did. Then I did the Matrix one. Okay.
What a day, You look lonely. I can fix that. You look like a good...
G-Sod.
Anyway, that one's not a funny one. That's kind of a sad one, but... That's actually the first one I made. And I have other ones. I don't have other ones yet. They're more live ones, but I'm not doing the live one. Because I haven't tested the stuff. I have it where if I was playing live ones, I have a couple of live ones where I click it. If I click it on, then it kicks on the lights in my green room, I guess you could call it. Wherever the green thing is set up, and then it shoots something there, then I walk in there, and then I can do it. Almost like Doc does. Dr. Disrespect. How I could do that in there, basically. But I haven't tested it. I haven't needed to test it. But anyway, because I haven't planned to use it anytime soon. But anyway, all right, guys. I appreciate y'all hanging out. I'd love it. Pointless if Friday around 5:30 is when I will stream. So if you want to hang out then, I'd love to have you. And Sunday. And Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday are for sure, definitely. I have streamed Saturdays before, but that's it. I haven't really streamed during the week just because it's too difficult a lot of times. Although this one wouldn't be as bad because the streams are a lot shorter, whereas the previous streams were like 4 hours. But anyway, I appreciate you stopping by, and I really do appreciate the follow. And hope to see y'all Friday.